Hey guys, Borg Careers, and welcome back to my FIFA 18 Liverpool career. Well, we're continuing on where we left off in last episode. So just as we enter December, we're almost halfway through season 3? It is, isn't it? Wait, it's 2018, we're going into 2019. The first season would be in line with the season we're currently going through, season 17, 18.
Dynamic when it comes to taking chances, a real threat to the opposition. Dybala, top scorer in the league this season, he's got that magic touch. And it's live!
Hi there, everybody. Martin
Tyler. I can't remember.
The former Arsenal.
No, it is. Yeah. It is because this is Dybala's first full season.
Excitement, and I've got it here today, Martin. Looking forward to
signed halfway through season one.
This is Swansea City's team for you today. Martin Olsen replaces Luke Shaw, who's looked vulnerable recently.
So this is only season 2.
Front end of the team.
Oh, my
big
God.
Reshuffle for Liverpool.
I'm jumping ahead. I'm thinking because I'm so close to season 3 in my secondary career mode.
The main striker is the Argentinian Paulo Dybala.
Why am I so far ahead in this?
Good defense.
So far behind in this game.
He can put them in front. Comes out off the goalkeeper. It's a fast start here.
They deserve that goal. They've been the better team early on.
Coutinho scores again. And just to reiterate, for those who didn't see the last episode, I am not selling Coutinho just because he offered in real life. If Barcelona want him in game, you know, they're more than welcome to bid for him, but I think they will find
they just haven't
negotiating with me a lot more infuriating than negotiating with the real life version of Liverpool. One.
Britain.
Imperial Cup.
Leon Britain.
But one player who might be on the way out is Divock Origi, who. This is something I will talk about.
On the move all the time and makes lots of these interceptions.
As the episode was coming to an end,
this could be a chance.
Transfer.
It must be. And in the shot go. Well, the old 1-2.
As much as I like Origi as a player, I think he's a great player.
Almost got there.
Unfortunately,
strong enough touch.
Yeah, he's annoyed with himself, isn't he? Having got a touch on it.
All he is his backup. I mean,
restarting.
It's injured. And I don't really need so many backups because I still have Danny Ings. I still have Tony Gomez. And I still have. I can't pronounce.
Leon Britton.
And
here they are on the attack. Shot up! Goalkeeper hangs on.
I think he is Nigerian. I'll check after the game, but I think he is Nigerian. So yeah, that's
Jordan.
Four players who play in the same position. I think there's somebody else.
Bonnie. And in he goes with the tackle.
Now
he's cut that out well.
I'll be thinking about how I'm gonna approach this. I think I will definitely sell Origi. Only if the price is right. Just because he's handed a transfer request, that doesn't mean his value goes down. His value is still the same.
Kieran Trippier.
It's like 26 or 27 million, maybe 28.
Using his physical power to protect the ball. A decent attacking position here, and they've got the advantage as well.
Which would put his.
Just read the intentions of the opposition.
Reasonable value.
The interception.
Of his.
Right, quickly guided through.
For his. Potential buyer
off the crossbar.
30 and back into the penalty area. Million mark.
Got to keep his nerve here. He's tackled well. It's a good challenge.
I think 34 million might be fair enough.
Wrists there from the keeper.
Depending on his value.
There's still Mane.
If it's
he has cleared
28, it'll be 34. If it's lower than
into the middle, it goes from Coutinho. He's gone for
33.
And it nearly paid off.
Yeah, really good technique there. Known for that kind of volley.
Enough. That's only a few extra million on top of his valuation. And of course, I will try and add in a sell on fee just because I can.
Coutinho. Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass. Good vision. Anticipated the direction of the pass and was able to intervene. He might be through. Well, the ball's gone past everyone in the penalty area and out away from danger. Well, the tackle there has led to a throw.
One rule, I will not sell to a Premier League rival. I couldn't help it with Jordan Henderson because Leicester paid his release clause, and I didn't think anyone would pay his release clause.
Britain.
Oh, and not a Premier League club, so there's that.
They've got numbers in this attack, and it
saying
looks
that
dangerous.
Jordan Henderson hasn't done anything since.
Kieran Trippier.
But Divock Origi is a different story because he's a striker. He will be a.
That's great defending.
Whenever
there,
I
stopping
play
that
a team, unless there's
and there goes the whistle for
bad team,
half-time.
And they could be relegation candidates. And I'm not gonna play. Maybe with the
time
with
now
the possibility
for the second half
that
to start.
Hoping that they might get relegated, so I will be limiting.
Looking good, this move.
Him. Like if it. If a championship club won,
Leon Britton. Then in the shot, go! He's way off target.
Might be extra.
Chan. Mohamed Salah. Striking forward purposefully.
I would say the Premier League clubs that my asking price will be in 60.
And they get it away.
Just so I scare the Premier League clubs away. Because,
well, the balls.
Then again, I have been wrong about this before, so. Before I say something that comes back to. Well, I would get 60 million.
Quick
so
note for your diary. Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture. Swansea City, they'll be facing Stoke City away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
He screened the ball well there. It's Salah now. Coutinho. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. Dybala never panicked, placed it past the goalkeeper.
That's for when January comes around.
He's half turned away, and that didn't help. If he'd have closed it down a bit more bravely, it might
I think
be better.
My main focus will be playing off
the other very off colour.
€1 billion offers for Paulo Dybala.
Coutinho.
And the man is just goal scoring machine.
Here's a chance to attack. Defender did well.
I could probably sell my whole front line for well in excess of
next game.
A record.
Yeah, they're playing Arsenal in the next match in the quarter final. I think it's going to be pretty easy for them. I think they'll find it pretty easy in this one.
Dybala's transfer doesn't make him my record signing any detail.
Dybala! Fantastic goal! Great power with the header. Excellently placed. Fine goal.
Well, I've always been an admirer of good headers. And this was certainly one of those. A thumping effort.
I have to say, it's so one-sided today, but all credit to the team that are racking up the goals. Olsen. Able to cut that out with some sharp movement. They've lost the ball, and this is how they love to play on the break. Oh, it's got to be.
Set up an easy goal for Paulo Dybala. He will slip, but he still put it in.
Thought that was going to hit the bar, but no, he's just crept under.
Let's get.
Unstoppable.
Well, there's good competition with goalkeeping in this team, and I think he might just be going down the pecking order after this.
Well, we know that you make a mistake, and invariably it comes back to haunt you, and that was a big mistake.
I don't think we expected this. Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline.
I think the only people not loving this right now are Swansea fans.
Sadio Mane. The real speed in this side comes from Sadio Mane. Emery. And now the shot.
Shan.
And the goalkeeper plunged to make the save. Liverpool have won a corner.
I don't know who this guy is, but I have no idea why the Swansea man are making a substitution now. 5-0 down.
Miscued
about 10 minutes.
He's heading, and you can see why there.
I'm sure he'll score 6 goals in 10 minutes.
Quick passing from Liverpool to open up the opposition if they can. The shot's on. Well, let's have another look at that, because it was a very, very tight call. They were in otherwise.
Well, when I saw it, first time of asking, I thought he was on, you know, but looking at the replay, what a good decision from the linesman that was.
Two really late substitutions. You know, I mean, you think he would have made these substitutions earlier.
This is a real shock. You can see it in the faces of the players, and you can hear it in the lack of noise, if you like, from the supporters.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to give their players any stick at the moment.
This is a problem I have with Jurgen Klopp in real life. He seems to wait until like the 70th minute. Yo, if we're, I understand doing that when we're winning games.
True.
I mean, if we're drawing or we're behind in the game.
And there it is.
Come on, you make some choices to make something happen. Don't wait till the game is practically over.
Well, this is rubbing salt in some pretty gaping wounds here.
Well, they just won't let up, will they? They're going to go to the final whistle.
Little surprising that it is as one-sided as this late in the game.
That's something I noticed the computer does a lot. They always seem to make
comfortable victory.
Substitutions really late, and they just make no sense.
The time added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Chan. There's usually a player out there when they need one, Liverpool, when they want to go into wider areas. It's a good ball, they could be in.
But then again, I'm not complaining. When they make stupid mistakes,
you can't put them in front.
Much easier to beat. Joe Gomez got up to 77 rate. Him and freaking Alexander Arnold are staying neck and neck. This is the guy I was talking about. He is Nigerian. Look at that. Normally I get stuff like that wrong, but sure enough. I'll give myself mad credit there. I was all ready to say, okay, maybe he's not Nigerian. But he is. He is Nigerian. Sure enough. F. Nice. I'll take that. I will. Thumbs up, it worked. He is indeed a Nigerian. I wasn't thinking of somebody else, thankfully. That would have been super awkward if he weren't Nigerian. quarter-finals.
They're on a bit of a roll, particularly from their last game. An away win against Swansea City.
You win by that margin and hit the comp.
What the hell? Who gave you the number 9?
And maybe this is one of them.
Yeah, maybe just caught cold there.
You know, he barely played. Remember, he's supposed to be
the Liverpool side.
Your main 4-3-3 number.
And they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks, it's quite a complicated job.
The last people we see him in an Arsenal shirt.
They've also got a funnel back when they haven't got the ball, so an onus on them.
Here's the Arsenal team.
Probably be the last time we see Alexis Sanchez in an Arsenal shirt. Or Mesut
in the fullback positions.
Arsenal just so many players. I know technically Emre Can is in the same situation. That this is the last.
What an enjoyable goal to watch.
Technically, Phil to
participate
in. Barrett didn't even make it through the full FIFA.
It was perfect.
And dang.
Angle on it here.
Saying that, there's still a chance for Sanchez and Ozil to move.
Nothing the manager can do at the moment.
And, according to the real life version of that man right there, Arsene Wenger, Sanchez will only go if Arsenal will get in a replacement. Good luck with that. I don't think
Sturridge
teams will be too eager to pay.
Well, that's not so much an
the price that Sanchez and Ozil should be worth. If they need some.
Well, then it goes
behind their contract.
Oh, they could have increased their advantage then.
Yeah, I think that would have been game over. It should have been moving that distance.
At the end of the season.
Is Bayerin, Mohamed Elneny. Now here's a chance. Referee's officiating properly here within the laws of the game.
I was waiting
quite
for
entitled to give that as a free kick. Well, early sometimes the players expect to get away with it, I think. That's good movement forward here. Chipping!
Nice finish, 2-0.
Good finish, no doubt, Martin, but what about the play before that?
Credit to him, that was a number 9 finish, but he doesn't play enough to warrant him having the number 9.
To put on a show, everybody except the opposition is enjoying this.
It's not often when you...
Oh, his number was probably changed when he signed up
Lunin. Pushing, I'm sure.
Widen the margin here to 2-0. Sanchez. Mohamed Elneny. Daniel Sturridge. Good position. They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous position now. Quick-witted and quick in his movement too to intercept there.
Can you give it to us? Yes? No.
It has to be quick. Francis Coquelin. Daniel Sturridge. Tight scenario here on the ball. Well, I like the look of this attack. Now, can he take them on? It's an excellent cross. Oh, that's great work by the goalkeeper.
Oh, Jorio, was that really the best header you could do?
And headed towards where a teammate can gather the ball.
One.
Striding forward, purposeful.
That's fine. Shut up!
That's fine work from the goalkeeper against an opponent. Great
work
by the goalkeeper. Great hands. Quick passing from Liverpool to open up the opposition if they can. Quaresma. Daniel Sturridge. stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging.
Well, the attack has done.
It's a quick break. Got to keep his nerve here. Here's the chance.
Oh, beautiful.
Off the post.
Talk about precision.
3-0. That should be that. Another semi-final for me.
First half. Sanchez. Daniel Sturridge. Coquelin. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Coquelin. And we're hearing there will be 3 added minutes here.
3 minutes.
Alexis Sanchez. Good strong tackle. Goes for it with a fist. No need to attack so much in the second half.
Halfway. A 2 of that semi-final. Of course, Manchester United are still in the competition.
There goes the whistle. Second half starting of this English League Cup quarter-final.
Well, we've seen some standout performances in the first half. I wonder if those lads can carry it through.
Anticipated the direction of the pass and was able to intervene. Here's a chance to attack. Opportunity now! Very good stop here. Coming up, a corner. Here comes the corner. He's blocked the shot well. Cleared away by the defender. There's some potential in this move. Now the shot! And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
I would be happy with that first 45 minutes. It was a good goal from him. Good overall performance, actually.
Xhaka.
Luckily,
he kicked awarded against Liverpool.
Come on, I barely touched.
Without doubt, I don't think there's any arguments there.
Did you see anything cynical?
The guy goes down from the slightest touch. And that's a yellow card.
Xhaka. Now this looks promising. Mesut Ozil.
Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woeful.
Sanchez. And shoots! Goalkeeper hangs on. The break is definitely on. He's in the clear. Oh, it could be. And he's taken
exactly.
The
super late.
Well, he's point blank range.
You've got to be there Wenger.
To score. You've got to be there to miss it as well, but he didn't.
You don't get away with that when you're a goalkeeper at this level.
No, rush of blood. And that's not what you want from your goalkeeper, and it's cost his side.
Neatly intercepted.
To
score! No, it's offside. And it looks as though they might be in to score. Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the Premier League fixture. For Liverpool, they'll be hosting Arsenal.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. I look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Good screening.
And them in for the second.
Lacazette. Quick-witted and quick in his movement.
Helen does do that.
Offside called, and we can see again now. Well, that's a good call.
Yeah, I think it was. And in the end, not a difficult one because there was a couple of yards in it, I think.
Those players can change anything.
Lacazette. He's on the move all the time and makes lots of these interceptions. It's often the fullbacks who drive them forward in wider areas. Liverpool.
It should be. It comes out off the goalkeeper.
Lacazette. Good work, really, to read the intention of the pass.
He's in. Really at the extent of his reach to make that very fine stop.
Corner coming up. He's put in the corner.
Out in front of goal,
only partially away from danger.
Corner again.
Here comes the corner.
Defended well.
He's taking a chance, but he's keeping the ball under some pressure.
Guiding it through. Has to score.
It was a real opportunity, but there might be a key moment.
What the hell was that?
From a defensive point of view.
How did you miss that?
He really did converge on him quickly. He didn't miss by much, but he's missed it.
I can't defend him.
Mesut Ozil. 4-0 here, and almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Arsenal after this, and they've done pretty well out here. They'll be pleased if they win it.
Guiding it through, getting forward well as a team now.
Look very good indeed, but the move has broken down. Taken quickly.
Well, there's one for him to chase in behind.
Wow. I was expecting to see the linesman holding up his flag.
Good defensive clearance there. Whipped in from the wide area. He pulled the cross really. Too deep.
Go to the ball before you try it. Whatever you try.
And the time is up. And the game.
Of course you did. Of course Man United won. You know what the semi-final is going to be, right? Huddersfield and Chelsea beat Wigan and Aston Villa. Fair play at Wimble. Welcome. Is that how it's said? I always call them Wickham. That's a different thing. Welcome. Getting to the quarterfinals. They beat a Premier League team in the last 16, so. Them losing to Chelsea. I mean, they can. That's probably. That's probably a huge deal in that club's history. I have to figure out something with that Ajax match. No, I don't want the Northern Ireland job. I don't care about international management. Anyway, thanks for watching. Enjoy. Smash that like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.